If you've been through some stuff and you come through and you're doing well right now, you are strong. What up, it's your girl Minna. In this video, we are talking all about the 8 things that I have learned in therapy. Now, this is pretty good stuff, okay? Because I've been in therapy for over a year now. So I've gotten some enlightenment that I wanna share with you in this video. If you are in therapy and you are comfortable sharing that, let me know in the comments below if you have been thinking about it and you now feel encouraged to do so because you know someone virtually who's in it. I hope that you enjoy the video. Make sure you're subscribed and follow my text community. It's free. You should be a part of it. And let's just go. So number one is, honestly, I have waited far too long. If you've been in therapy, then you know exactly what I mean. It just gives such a revelation that I never even knew existed, never even knew that I could have access to, never even knew would be so helpful for me. I have heard of therapy here and there, but I don't know. Now I do. But growing up, I did not know anybody that was in therapy. Anybody. And that's a problem. That's a problem. I mean, I'm entitled to therapy just like the next person is. Granted, it costs money, and we'll get to that. But it is so helpful. It has been so helpful. It has been so eye-opening for me. And it's just so clear that I've waited entirely too long to be at my big age and now be getting revelations about things from childhood that it's just like, yo, if I was in therapy in high school, I'd be better along. Or maybe I would have learned lessons faster. But we all know that God is sovereign, he's in control. So, you know, it is what it is. Here we are now, life is not over. I've gotten a lot of revelations now that make my life a lot better, that bring a lot more understanding to things that I just did not know before. I just didn't understand earlier. So it's just undeniable that I have waited entirely too long. So if you're in therapy right now, I want you to let me know if this is your first time or if you've been in therapy for like, you know, a few other times. Because from what I understand, you know, you may not be in therapy for year after year, but you might go for a stint and then do checkups, or you might go for a stint and then be like, find that you don't need anymore for a while, and then perhaps in a few years you go for another stint. So from what I understand, you really just make it how you want to make it. You tailor it to what works for you, and right now is working for the kid, okay? The second thing that I've learned is, yo, it is not just for crisis management. It is not just when you are feeling like you're out of control. It is not for just when you're feeling depressed. It is not just for when you're feeling anxious. It is not just for grief. It is not just for divorce. It is not just for marriage counseling. It is for everyday life. To me, if you want to be a woman or a man of substance, someone who is just balanced and reasonable and in control of self and all the things in between, you need to be in therapy. Like, it is for the everyday person. And obviously I'm saying this because of the stigma that goes behind it, that you're in therapy because you're in crisis. No, this is a person that you're speaking to. I feel like I'm like promoting therapy. Shoot, I need to be sponsored. It's not a sponsor, girl. I'm just from my heart because I know how much I benefited from it. You're talking to a person that knows what he or she is talking about. I use a woman that knows what she's talking about, that can provide you, if you found a good one, I mean, thank God I have found good ones, who can provide you with sound, non-biased, judgment-free advice that is proven to work, and they work with you through lots of different things, right? A lot of us grow up and we like to vent to our friends and family and we expect that these people can help us. They can't help us. They need therapy just as much as you do. Like, come on. I'm not saying that I don't believe in talking to friends. I do, but there's a limit. Therapists know what they're talking about. They have gone to school to study this stuff, okay? They provide much greater, in my experience, a much greater revelation than I've ever experienced in my life from any adult, any friend, anybody, okay? It is just a no-brainer. And honestly, it's good to just check in. Like, it's not about, I'm in distress, I need to go to therapy until I no longer feel like I'm in distress. No, it's like day to day, this is my life. I want to make sure that I am managing my time well. I am emotionally healed. I am emotionally healthy. I am, you know, taking care of self. Maybe you're in college and you're overwhelmed. Therapy is helpful. Maybe you're a new mom. Therapy is helpful. Maybe you're newly married. Therapy is helpful. Maybe you've been married for 10 years. Therapy is helpful. Like, it's just for all the things. You see what I'm saying? Maybe you and your child have a strained relationship. Therapy is helpful. You and a parent have a strained relationship. Therapy is helpful. You know, you've got trauma in your life. Therapy is helpful. Because as I'm learning, I believe every single person on this earth has experienced some sort of trauma. I mean, that's just, I want to go ahead on a limb and just say it's a proven fact, you know, although I'm not citing any sources, honestly. It is just so helpful. So just like we go to the dentist, you know, every 6 months, to go to the OB/GYN every year or whatever, however often you go to your primary care when you your little sniffles, why not be in therapy? Listen, again, I feel like I am pushing this, but I just want to share what I have learned because it has been so life-changing. And as I go through all the 10 things that I've learned, you'll see exactly what I mean. It is just good for like a tune-up, you see? But obviously when you hire someone like virtual, for instance, for me, I'm online, it's every week. You might just hire someone where you are going to see them in person or even online, and you might pay per session. I pay monthly and it's per week, okay? BetterHelp.com, use my link below to get a free week. And it gives me, I think, a free week. It's not sponsored, but you know, they can holler at your girl. They can holler at your kid. You know what I'm saying? The third thing that I've learned, girl, is honestly, you don't know until you know. Like, you don't know that you need therapy until you're in therapy. Like, me and my girlfriend, who's also in therapy, literally, you always talk about like, yo, therapy? Like, it's just two words. Yo, therapy? And that's all it takes, because we know what we mean by that. It's just like a constant revelation. Like, wow. For instance, I recently learned that I was told that because, you know, there are attachment styles. So there are four different ones. I can't recall all the four. Okay. But my attachment style is anxious attachment. Now, on the higher end, or this way, because now that you're on the screen, on the higher end, anxious attachment could mean codependency, and that is not me, far from it. But on the middle lower end, it means fear of abandonment, and that's me. I did not know that growing up. But when I found that out, I was like, this explains so much. If I'd known this when I was a teenager, it would have helped me so stinking much. So now my big age, I'm like, I have fear of abandonment? Yeah. Now that you say it, that does make sense. Okay, so now when I look back over my life, like I'm saying a song, when I look back over my life, I'm like, wow, all of this makes sense. And it's that kind of stuff that continues to come up in conversations that I'm like, yo, you're right. You're right. And I love my therapist, right? She's this old white lady. And I say that with love. We call my mom old lady, okay? So I say that with love and respect. She's so sweet. She's so sweet and she's so intrigued by what I do. It's so interesting because she's not familiar with it. And she's so like, I talk just like this, you know? And she's always with it. And she like, yo, she be keeping up. She's so funny. And she be keeping up and she be understanding and stuff. And I literally talk just like this. And when I'm explaining something and I'm really angry, I be talking and, you know, and she be keeping up. Praise the Lord, she be keeping up. So I really am grateful for her. I really, really am, like, honestly. Number four lesson that I learned is that I have unhealed childhood trauma, okay? Stay with me, all of us do. Whether it's neglect, whether it's abuse, whether it was emotional or physical or verbal, whether it was needs going unmet, that's neglect, sorry. I can't think of all the other things, but yes. Okay, and I knew, like, I can pinpoint areas of my childhood that were very traumatic for me. I can pinpoint being verbally abused. I can pinpoint fighting physically. I can pinpoint times where emotionally my needs were not met. I can pinpoint times where I was in serious distress and fear for nourishment and housing and all of those things, right? But I just, without knowing much, just chalked it off to this was just my life. It's not like I sat and I said, wow, I was in some cases, what's that word? Parentified, where you are taking on more responsibility as a child than you should, like than a child should. Or let's say in this case, I was worried so much about survival as opposed to being a child or being a teenager. So I was under distress for a period of time. So stuff like this, where in therapy we're talking and I'm like, yo, you kind of right though. Like what you saying is right. Yo, that's true. And it makes other things make more sense. It makes my behavior and my outlook on things now and even up after those situations happen, it makes so much more sense. It makes my behavior and feelings and emotions and experience, even in marriage, make more sense. It makes my choices when I was a teenager in 20s make sense. It just makes things make so much sense. It helps me understand parenting. Why do I respond the way that I respond? Why am I the way that I am right now? You know, why do I get upset about certain things? And how do I handle my upset? What do I do when I'm in distress? All of that. It's like, yo, wow, okay? So, you know, I'm not trying to like break all my stuff down right now, but I'm just trying to say that I have learned a tremendous amount about myself. Does that make sense? I have learned a tremendous amount, whatever. I have learned a lot by myself, girl. And it's just stuff that I just never would have known if I was not in therapy with someone that knew exactly what they were talking about. Not a friend, not a family member who's also trying to figure it out. Like all of us trying to figure things out. We cannot advise each other all the time on certain things because you don't know what's going on. I don't know what's going on. Like, what is this? I don't like all that. I need sound advice. And I have benefited the whole entire time. Okay. I've been in therapy for over a year. Number five, it's worth it. Okay. I pay $45-$50 a week and it's worth it. I know that some therapists in person, I believe everyone's in online now, I don't know, but I know that some therapists in person can charge 100 plus per session. No, mine is like $50-ish per session and it's charged per month. So BetterHelp is what I use. I learned about it through Woman Evolve, girl. Sarah Jakes began Woman Evolve, and one of her first sponsorships was BetterHelp. And she kept mentioning it and I was like, yo, I should give it a shot. Again, I did not know anybody who'd been in therapy and I was like a little hesitant, like, dang, I don't know, but I knew I needed to. I just knew I needed to. And I'm so glad I did. And I'm so glad I was listening to that podcast and I found out about it. So these ads that go around, it might seem like, oh God, it's not a sponsorship. Nah, sis. Some of the stuff is really, really great. And I know that God spoke through that podcast to get me into therapy because I've just, so much has been revealed that has been helpful for me. Like it's just been helpful for someone to say, wow, you are so strong. Wow, you've been through so much. Wow, you have come a long way. You should be proud of yourself, right? If you're someone that's always hard on yourself, always feeling like you're never enough, always feeling like stuff's always on your shoulders, you bear responsibility for your family, whatever it is just so helpful. And it's a breakthrough for a therapist to hear you talk and say, wow, you've done a lot. But, you know, kudos to you. You should be proud of yourself. Because if you're someone who's waiting on someone in your family to say that to you, to thank you, to honor you for all of your sacrifices or whatever it is, and you're not getting that, sometimes just your therapist saying that to you can be so freeing. It can be so freeing. Like, you have no idea. My therapist said to me, you are so strong. Wow, you've gone through a lot. Like, in my head, I'm like, I mean, I didn't think it was a big deal. I mean, it's a big deal. It's a big deal. But you know how you just minimize stuff because it's just been your life, so you're like, whatever. But no, when she said it, and she said this toward the end of our session, so it sat with me for days, and I was like, wow, yo, she's right. I am strong. You know, many of us don't want to give ourselves that title because you don't want to feel too like you're bigging up yourself. Nah, sis, like, if you've been through some stuff and you come through and you're doing well right now, your mind is sane, you are strong. And so when she said that to me, I was like, all right. You know, I'm being funny right now, but honestly, I was like, yeah, I guess so, right? Like, I didn't immediately say like, yeah, I know, I did that. I came through, you know, I came through the storm and I weathered it and I went to school and I did well and I kept a steady job and I didn't fall into drugs and all kind of stuff. Like, I did well. It didn't come out of my mouth immediately, but as I thought about it, I was like, yo, man, she's right. You know what I'm saying? I did that. So it, again, just that encouragement has been so powerful for me. So like I said, it is very worth it. I understand that everyone has to look at their budget and see what works, but with BetterHelp.com, honestly, it has been really affordable to be in therapy for a long time. And so you can stop it at any point if you feel like, you know, a month was cool. No more. I don't need any more. I'm good. I feel healed. Great. If you want to keep on going, feel free to do that. But I encourage you to definitely take the free week. You get one session. You can always chit chat with your therapist in the app or the website. And then you can do video or phone call visit. You can write in a journal and your therapist can read it and respond to you during the week. I love it. I really, really do. Number six is, honestly, everybody needs it. I need it. You need it. Yo, even the people that be like, nah, man, I'm good. I'm good. I know myself. Yo, it be the prideful ones. Yo, it be the ones that think they got it. They know what to do. They don't need nothing from nobody. They don't need to hear anything from it. Are you kidding me? The cafeteria worker, she needs it. The bus driver, he needs it. The police officer, he needs it. The nurse, the doctor, the student who's in first year grad school needs it. Everybody needs it. I even said to myself, I'm like, we need to put aside a savings account for our children to go to therapy. Because I've worked in education, okay, that's my career up until now. Working in education alongside students, I have seen and heard and gone through with students so much, and I'm like, God, if they only could get therapy, if they only can convince their parents to put them in therapy, they would be so much further along. But you know, how much can I do, right? So I'm like, we need to have a savings account for our children set aside just for therapy because they need it as teenagers, and then they'll understand how normal it is. It doesn't mean you're psychotic. It means you actually care about yourself and your well-being and who you are as a person, your mental health, to be more stable, because it just needs to happen. Teens need therapy, sis. Everybody needs therapy. therapy, honey. It's not something that means you're psychotic. My God, today, you know, we don't go to the OB gym because we have cervical cancer. You know, we go there to prevent that. To me, therapy is preventative. Prevents you, I feel, honestly, barring any extreme cases, but it prevents you from a huge breakdown of some sort that could come on because of stress and anxiety and all these things. So I'm just saying. Number seven thing that I've learned, honestly, is that I like I said earlier, speaking to an older woman, not a man. Even my doctor is a woman. I do not like a male doctor. I just don't. It's just not my thing. And when it comes to a therapist, I feel better talking to a woman. And an older woman, because on BetterHelp, you can see, search through and pick out your therapist. You read their bio, see what they look like. And I'm like, nah, you've been doing this 4 years, nah, chill. You ain't gonna come and practice on me. I need someone that's older in the game, been through some stuff, been married or is married, and just has been through the life, okay? I'm not trying to get you alongside me. Here we are trying to figure things out. No, ma'am. You didn't just finish grad school and come and you gonna take me on as a doctoral student or whatever you're doing. Nah, I can't do that. It's like giving birth in a hospital and here come all the students. No, goodbye. I'm not signing this off. They can leave, right? Like, do not bring students in here. I want someone that knows what they're doing. So I prefer someone older and I prefer a woman. And that's, I've had three. One was I had seen her for like four sessions, but all women. I just prefer women. So if you are in therapy, let me know if you don't really care about whether or not it's a man or woman, and also let me know if you prefer younger, around the same age, older. What do you like? Or what would you do if you're thinking about therapy? Would you be looking to go with someone older? I'm just curious. And then the last thing, number eight, is honestly, it has opened my eyes. Open the eyes of my heart, Lord. You know, no, for real, it has opened my eyes. It has given me a new lease on life. It has helped me to let go of pain from the past that I didn't realize was still in control of my future. I know that sounds like some sort of poem, but it's true. There were things that I hadn't yet processed through fully, that while talking to my therapist, it helped me process it fully. It helped me forgive and move through a few things that were really, really important. And it helped me look at and formulate how to talk with people in my life about certain things that were important to me, and how to do so in a way that didn't come off too aggressive, but allowed that person to also speak on their behalf so that we can hash out some things. It's good, man. Sometimes we have good intentions about, let's say, tough conversations that we want to have, but the way that we go about it, it puts that the person on defense. Therapy has helped me to see different ways to approach difficult conversations, honest to God. It really has. And then it has further cemented the idea that I truly am in control of my life. I truly am in control of how I feel each day, of course, barring anything extreme, but just in the sense of me making the choice to be happy, making the choice to set aside time for myself. Watch my video on the top 10 things that I do to make myself happy. It goes along this line in a way, but honestly, it has just opened my eyes to the idea that I am in control in many ways of how I feel, and I can make that decision to heal from the past, to get over stuff that's been holding me back. You see what I'm saying? Make better choices, put myself first, that kind of a thing. So yo, therapy is where it's at. I understand that it can be a little expensive, but the way I see it is, if I'm over here buying all this makeup, all these clothes, traveling, eating out, and whatever, then I have the money to pay for a therapist that's going to help me in my life each week. Like, it don't make no sense. You see what I'm saying? For many of us, we have the extra money, but we just don't see the benefit of it. And I'm here to tell you right now. I wish you would go to a therapy session. I wish you would go to therapy 4 weeks for 1 month. And I wish you'd be like, I wasted my time. I wish you would. Like, I just need someone to tell me, because I don't believe it's possible. I don't believe it's possible to go to therapy for a month, because the first session, you're getting to know. I mean, how deep you gonna go in the first session? You know what I'm saying? Go to therapy for a month and you can't tell me you didn't go and then feel like, yo, wow, we actually uncovered a lot of things, you know? It's so worth it. And maybe I feel some people are avoiding taking the band-aid off on things that they've just shoved. Like, they're avoiding opening the closet and all the trash falling out. I understand that. Like, we've had discussions that I did not really want to go into that unearthed a lot of pain that I did not realize was still there. I understand that. But I encourage you, because a lot of times we don't understand how unhealed pain is actually wreaking havoc on our bodies. It can actually still wreak havoc on our bodies. It's just gotta go. It's gotta go. We gotta release it. I feel like this is becoming a really spiritual video. You know what I'm saying? But it's really important. It honestly is. So those are the eight lessons that I have learned in therapy. I implore anybody, and maybe maybe what I can do is I could gift a free month, can't I? Should I gift a free month of therapy on BetterHelp? Let me do that. I can pay for the first month, and then you on your own after that. You know what I'm saying? Comment below anything that you feel regarding what I've just talked about. And I'm going to choose one person, y'all, because come on now. I'm gonna choose one person by the grace of God, and I'm gonna communicate with you and stuff, and I'm gonna gift you 1 month of therapy with BetterHelp because it has just been so life-changing for me. I cannot deny that. I just can't. And of course, if you decide to go in person, do your own thing going on forward, go for that. But it's just easy. I saw the option one day and I was like, oh, I can actually give this as a gift. This is fantastic. So I think it's a great gift to give out. Okay. I'm glad you watched this video. Let me know below if any of it resonated with you. What are you thinking about what I was saying? You know, all the things. Comment and let me know. But as always, I'm glad that you're here. I'm glad that you watch my videos, girl. I'm glad that you're on this journey with me because your girl is growing and learning and having fun while we at it. Okay. Make sure you watch some more videos before you go because your girl is out here putting in work. Let's go. All right. Bye.